In this video, we're going to learn how to add 3D effects using Adobe Premiere Elements version 13. Here's an example of what I'd like to show you how to do. Just as a disclaimer, if you ever see a spider with red spots on its butt, leave it alone. Its sting could kill you. Let's get started. We've got a blank session in Adobe Premiere Elements. Let's go ahead and add some videos. How about my little spider and a hummingbird? The effect that you're going to be using here is a 3D effect, and let's just go ahead and get started and add one of those effects. So let's go to our Effects tab and find the basic 3D. It's in my frequently used, I'm not sure where it is in your palette, just search for basic 3D and drop that onto your video one timeline. Now it's going to come in with a very goofy orientation. Don't worry about that. We're going to change all these effects to get something a little bit better and animate it. All right, so the step number one, let's just turn this into a normal kind of a view so we're looking straight at it. So let's change the swivel to zero, the tilt to zero, and the distance to image zero as well. Now we're looking at this in sort of the default size. All right, now let's go ahead and add some neat effects to this thing. So let's just say we want to start about here, and I want the video to go to a slightly different orientation. If you don't have your Applied Effects tab showed, this little palette of commands, when you pick the Applied Effects, you'll see Motion, Opacity, and the newly added 3D one that we just added. There's a little eye here that you can toggle it on or off. If you want to just temporarily shut it off, you can do that. We're going to play with the animation in just a second. You can reset all of your settings if you want to, and of course, that's how you delete your effect. If you don't have this cute little timeline down here, chances are your little stopwatch up here or your show hide keyframes is off. Just make sure that is on. That way you can control settings over time. So right about here, I want all these settings to be preserved. So let's remember swivel, remember tilt, remember distance to image. And notice how it puts this little dot here and that remembers that keyframe. So if we pan over just a little bit, and I don't know how far you want to go, a few seconds or so, let's change the settings to maybe minus 45 for the swivel. And how about distance, say 40. Now I've played around with these, so I kind of know what these settings are, so you're going to have to kind of mess with them yourself. Now if you notice the image isn't in the sort of in the center of the screen, or it's centered, but I don't want it there, I want it to the left or right hand side, we're going to go to our Motion tab, and same thing for the position. I just want to change this to somewhere around, oh, I don't know, maybe start at the very beginning, and we'll leave it at 960, and somewhere around here, we're going to change this to 1600. And you'll see now the video sort of does this 3D effect, and it pans itself over. Now, I don't like how it sort of keeps moving over after the effect is done in the 3D effect, so what we're going to do, expand our 3D, and this little keyframe button, you can go to the next or go to the back keyframe. We'll just go to the very next one, go back to our motion, and drag this little dot here right on top of that red line to sort of snap it to that location. It doesn't actually snap, but you get the idea of moving it around. Now we can see how this video rotates, and it sort of slides over to the right-hand side of the screen. Now this is obviously way too slow. I don't like the lag in here where it just does nothing for a few seconds, but you get the idea on being able to control that. So let's go ahead and fix that. Actually, it really kind of is bothering me. So we're going to go back to our basic 3D, go to this first keyframe, and turn off that swivel, turn off that keyframe for tilt, and the last one for the distance to image. Now it's going to have, I remember these here, 0 and 0 to add those keyframes in. Every time you type in a value, it remembers that that setting. So for example, if I want to remember the tilt here, just change it to whatever, and it does some very, very goofy kind of a setting. So if you don't like it, hover over to it or snap to it and delete that keyframe. Now we should see this thing tilt and pan all at the same time. Now again, this is way, way too slow for me, but you get the idea on how to add this. All right, right about here, I want this other video to come in of my cute little spider. So let's bring in that video. Where is he? Spider. Right about here. And what we'd like him to do is start sort of vertical, if you will. So you're looking at the, you can't see anything. We want it to kind of fold out. So again, process is generally the same. Let's go to our effects, add a 3D. And you can notice how the spider there is always in that that orientation. So here's where we want to change it. So let's go ahead to the very beginning. How do you get to the beginning? Just hit the page up to get to the very beginning of the of any of these video clips that you have. So the swivel here, let's just change it to say 90. So I'm looking at actually at the end of it now. You might not be able to see it, but right there at 90. In fact, it might even be minus 90, but close enough for right now. We'll change it to 90. And the tilt, we want that to be 0. Let's just type it in. And the distance to image, let's just do it, say, 50, because I don't want it to be full size when it starts off. So now that you see what this tilt does, or the swivel, now we can change it to 90. Now you can see exactly what why I tilted a little bit the swivel, so you see what the other settings we're going to do. Now at that point in time, let's remember everything. Tilt, swivel, and distance, and it adds this small little dot here to remember that that keyframe. Somewhere about here, for example, I don't know exactly where that's going to end up being, maybe a little bit further out. Let's change our swivel to 45 and our distance, say 40. Now, I know what all these settings are because I've been playing around with this thing, so I just am typing them in, but you're going to have to kind of experiment on your own to see what that looks like. Now that after the hummingbird is set, you'll see the video of the spider sort of rotate around and get in the right position. Now, what I want to do is change it its location. So let's go to the emotion tab, and it is going to start off at 960 by 540. So let's remember that. And then somewhere around here, when it's all done moving around, we want to change this to somewhere around 300 to 540. Again, I know what these values are. Not 3D, 30, 300. And to get that in the right position, I'm going to go to my basic 3D, align myself to that keyframe. Now when I go to the motion, I know exactly where to drag that small keyframe to. Now you can't get it exactly on there, but if you zoom in, you can get it close enough. So now when I play my video clips here, it's going to be very slow, of course, but you get the idea that first the hummingbird video rotates over using that 3D effect, and it slides over as well with the motion, and then the spider sort of fans out, if you will, and it gets in the right location. So that's it, a quick short video on how to change the angle of videos with your 3D effect. I hope you learned something. Thanks for watching.